yesterday for you guys was that the Lakers and the Pelicans are in some intense trade talks for Anthony Davis. And so we're looking shoes. And apparently the trade package for Anthony Davis that the Lakers are offering is Lonzo Ball, surprising, and the fourth overall pick. I'm not sure if Josh Hart is included in that package, but apparently the Lakers are not, or at least I don't want to say not, are trying to withhold Kyle Kuzma as much as they can, which could hurt them in the future. Now, if I was the Lakers, I would rather keep Lonzo, just because I feel like a good point guard is harder or more hard to come around than a scoring wing, you know. No offense to Kyle Kuzma, he's a great wing. But first, this is second or third, it's going to be his third year, and he's already up there in age. While, you know, Brandon Ingram's only, I don't think he's even 20 yet. He's not even 21. I know that for a fact, but chilling with Lonzo, very young. Kyle Kuzma's the oldest out of the group. And like I said before, it's harder to find a good point guard than, you know, a scoring wing like Kyle Kuzma is. So I don't really know why they would rather give up Brandon Ingram than Kyle Kuzma when Brandon Ingram is younger, but almost, or maybe a little less, of a better player. So I guess they really like how Kyle Kuzma is on and off the court, which I understand. Kyle Kuzma is a really good guy, so to see how that goes. Nick Young on the Wizards, Swaggy P. Drew Holiday back when he was a Sixer. What else? Yeah, but I guess the Pelicans are only going to be talking to the Lakers if they include Kyle Kuzma, which hopefully the Lakers do. If I was LeBron, I'd be screaming at the Lakers to keep talking to them. Look at that, the Morris twins over there in Kansas. Didn't even get drafted yet back in 2011. Also, Kyrie Irving signed with Rock Entertainment, Rock something, but anyways, it's Jay-Z's label. Jay-Z's helps with that organization or something like that for agencies for different things, and apparently Kyrie Irving signed with them, which means, if you know Nets management, I think Jay-Z owns some of the New Jersey Nets, so, or Brooklyn Nets, excuse me. I'm very interested to see if Kyrie's actually serious about going to the Nets, because, I mean, the Nets have D'Angelo Russell, who's an all-star. So does that mean, and D'Angelo, again, is also a restricted free agent, so does that mean, because the team's gonna give D'Angelo a lot of money this offseason, like, I mean, the Magic, you know, the Wolves, teams that, you know, the Suns, teams that need a point guard, are gonna pay up for D'Angelo Russell, obviously, because he's an all-star. Like, I really like D'Angelo Russell's game. So are they just not gonna match that contract, or are they gonna match that contract and just have a bunch of cap problems when they have Kyrie, who's gonna have a max, D'Angelo, who's gonna have a very big contract, and then you have Spencer Dinwiddie, who's just kinda off to the side, and Caris LeVert, who's off to the side. That's gonna be very awkward, because you have four very capable guards. Not one, not two, not three, no, well, four, yeah, four cards. It's going to be very interesting to see if Kyrie goes there, how that's going to all work out. Sorry if there's a very bad glare. It's kind of hard to fix it, but let's see here. Golden State Warrior. Why would it say that? That's really weird. performance we've ever seen. Blake, B-L-A-K-E, Griffin, G-R-I-F-F-I-N, is changing the Clippers and the league at large. Which he very much was. He was definitely a force to be reckoned with. I always thought these were pretty cool. These, like, better shot, two-way keys you can buy, and you can put them on your fingers and help you shoot better. This is J.J. Redick promoting it. Which, I mean, hey, man, if J.J. Redick actually wore it, J.J. Redick's a good shooter. You have a basketball shooting aid. Wrist rollers. We used to have those at our gym at school. Those things are pretty, like, just really hard to do, even with that small of weight. They're pretty hard to do. To see if they go there, and by them, I mean Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. So who knows what's gonna happen to them? I was speaking of them together. They could still, I guess, go to the Knicks if they wanted to, but who knows? I think the most reasonable free agent's probably Kemba, which is not bad. But like I said before, in a podcast interview, I've heard. Said before that he doesn't like big cities, so New York is the biggest city probably in the world. So I don't know, maybe he'll go, but he said in that podcast he doesn't really like big cities, but I don't know. This is back when they had Amare and Carmelo on the same team. They were so close to doing something really good there, but Amare wasn't really himself, and Carmelo couldn't really do much by himself because no one else would come to the Knicks. So that was pretty rough for them. You got Tim Duncan here as well. But yeah, so today is the Game 6 of the NBA Finals, and I'm very interested to see what happens. You know, if Klay Thompson's going to have a good game. Klay and Steph definitely need to have good games in order for them to feel like some also some video ideas or just to say hi. I'll say hi back. I don't really mind, but I think I'm gonna say it.